was echt als de trein begint te stoppen. We zijn gearriveerd en mijn hart gaat harder kloppen.
De deur gaat langzaam open, zonnestralen door de kier. Ik kijk de conducteur aan en zeg, lekker weertje hier.
Hij lacht en lijkt dat ook te vinden.
Kijkt omhoog en zegt,
kom minder.
Kom minder, kom hier niet vandaan en het klinkt een beetje raar.
Zitten op terras en bestel natuurlijk geen fris. Ik proef nieuwe avonturen, volgens mij zitten we goed. Iedereen voelt zich nog nuchter, maar dat zit hier in het bloed.
En wie is toch die baby die ik overal zie hangen? Die blije eierbal zonder naam en zonder tanden. Bovenop het forum zien wij de hele stad. Bovenop het forum denk ik had ik maar een dak te ras. Tegen nieuwe beste vrienden zeg ik wat een uitzicht. En zij zeggen
kom minder.
Kom minder, kom hier niet vandaan en het klinkt een beetje raar. Kom minder, het lijkt wat negatief, maar volgens mij is dat het niet. Kom minder, het voelt wel oké, dus ik doe maar lekker mee. Kom minder, kom minder.
Ik ruik het feest tussen de 3 en de 9. Mensen druppelen naar binnen, het is bier dat die regent. Dus ik doe een regentandje, wil alleen maar genieten. Ik schreeuw mee met de muziek.
Dikke bak met bier!
Er loopt een meisje op me af, net zo mooi als deze stad. Dan gaat ze naast me zitten en begroet me met een lach. We drinken samen een martini, totdat zij het erop waagt. Ze komt nog wat dichterbij en vraagt.
Wat vind je eigenlijk van mij? Zie je mij een beetje zitten?
Dus ik zeg.
Kom minder, kom hier niet vandaan en het klinkt een beetje raar. Kom minder, het lijkt wat negatief, maar volgens mij is dat het niet. Kom minder, het voelt wel oké, dus ik doe maar lekker mee. Kom minder, kom minder.
My love has got no money, he's got his strong beliefs. My love has got no power, he's got his strong beliefs. My love has got no pain, he's got his strong beliefs. My love has got no money, he's got his strong beliefs. One more and more people just want more and more freedom and love. What he's looking for, one more and more people just want more and more freedom and love. What he's looking for.
Spirit.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the first KIK lecture of this year. My name is Marit Dotinga. I will be the coordinator of external affairs for Study Association KIK. We will have three guest lectures today. These are student entrepreneurs, and the first one is Huub Danker from Laser Game Verhuur Groningen.
Yes, now I'm going to tell something about my company. I have my own company, which is Laser Game Verhuur Groningen. With my company, I rent out laser game equipment and archery tech equipment, and also many more. I started while I was a student. I started 5 years ago, and I started as a hobby, just renting out 12 laser game guns.
Sets.
Yeah. And there was so much demand that I expanded much
a lot. You expanded quicker than you expected.
Yes. Yeah. And now I have more than 500 laser game guns, and still expanding. And while I was a student, I used a lot of word of mouth to get new customers, and used Google Ads to place my websites on top of Google. And while I was a student, I was member of the Study Association HMV Actis, and there I got a sponsorship with, and they now every year they play laser game when they're
with their active members.
With their active members, and I have now also many more sponsorships with other associations and companies. And
you're still doing it all by yourself, the whole company? Do you have any employees?
I have now one employee who started half a year ago, something like that.
So where did you get the idea to start this whole company?
The idea started 5 years ago, when we as a friend group bought 12 laser game guns, and we didn't do much with the laser guns, so I thought maybe rent them out.
Yeah, so you bought them to play yourself, and then you thought, let's rent them out.
And there was much demand, so I thought, no, buy more, sell more. And so a hobby became a job, and now it's my full-time job.
Yeah. So you didn't start with the idea, like, I'm going to start my own company, and then you did this, it was
kind of
on accident.
Yeah, on accident, yes.
Do you have any regrets, or do you have anything you would have done differently if you looked back?
I don't have regrets, but there, when you start your company, you always make a mistake. So I had some trouble with supply when I sent out the laser guns to a customer in, let's say, Amsterdam. They need to be shipped with PostNL, and sometimes there is some delay, and when that happens, I'm a little bit in stress, so will it be on time? But unfortunately, until now, it was always good.
Yeah. But do you find it difficult to give such things away, because once you ship the project, it's out of your hands?
No, it's... Yeah, I have never had any trouble with that.
All right. Do you have any things you would have you? Do you have anything that went really well that you would do again, or you would recommend, or do you have any tips for other students?
Yeah, I really recommend when you are a student, you can try everything and use Duo to lend money. And use that money to start your own company, and start small and grow bigger, and make mistakes. It's not a problem when you make a mistake. You can always solve it, or have somebody else who can help you. And you are all in the student association. There are much more people who can help you. So don't be afraid to make a mistake and just try it. And yeah.
Yeah, yeah, so you've never felt like you were alone or you had to do it all by yourself. You felt
so sometimes, yeah, when you have your own company, yeah, you are by your own and you have to do it by yourself. So, yeah, you are really, how do you say that? Yeah, you have to do it all by yourself and you don't have some other employees when you start. So,
yeah.
But you can, you will live, yeah, you will get used to it.
Yeah, yeah. Right. And can you tell us a bit more about the way you you market yourself? How do you find your new customers, and or do they find you?
Yeah, they find me by word of mouth of previous customers, and I'm on top of Google when you search for a laser game in Groningen.
Yeah,
you will find me, and yeah. With the Google Ads campaign, I will be also on top of the page, and then they will find me and make a reservation.
Yeah, well, sounds nice.
Yeah.
Do we have any questions, perhaps, from the people watching? And maybe in the meantime, you can tell us some do's and don'ts you learned.
Yeah, when I have had in the past I had a problem. I was fully booked, and then I accepted another reservation, and I didn't have the equipment. So I thought, I have a problem. What should I do now? And I just thought, yeah, I can call them and say, sorry, I don't have it. I made a mistake, or just buy a new one.
Yeah.
So I just bought more.
So the customers wouldn't notice that you did that.
No. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it sounds like a good tip always to just solve things on your own. Well, not on your own, but as least possible.
How old were you when you started? I was 19.
And you're now 24?
25.
25. Okay. So you've been at it quite a long time.
Yeah.
What was your name again? His name is Huub Danker.
Huub Danker, yes.
You also find him if you are looking for a laser game verhuur or laser game rental, I don't know, Groningen.
Yeah, laser game verhuur Groningen. And when people, I don't own a building with the laser game, people pick the laser games up at my so place and go to their own location or park or school. They can play,
so they
everywhere.
Can play everywhere. I believe I've seen people play outside indeed. And but do you have your own building where you give them out, or is that just your house?
That's my house.
Oh, that's cool. How many guns did you start with, and how many do you have now?
I started with 12, and now I have over 500 and many extras like smoke machines, lasers, and arrows.
And when you started, did you have any idea that you would grow this big?
No.
Could you
no.
have ever imagined that?
No, it's slowly grows.
Okay. I see some questions about the aanwezigheid. At the end, you will get a QR code and you can scan it, and then you can just put your name there and then it will be all right. Maybe to round up, do you have any tips or things you would give to people to, like, what should you really do, or if people are doubting or questioning if they start their own company?
Don't be afraid to ask for help. There are at the Studio Association KIK, there are many people who have already a company. Ask them for help. They are willing to give advice and help you.
Yeah, expand your network and don't be afraid to ask people for help. I see another question. Isn't it illegal to be in public with anything that could resemble a gun?
No, they are really toy-like. They are, you can play everywhere except when you are disturb the public safety. So you can't play in the shopping mall, but in the park like Noorderplantsoen or Stadspark, you can play freely.
Yeah, that's cool. Oh, there are even more questions coming in. How high was your initial investment, and when did you start focusing on marketing more?
I don't know the right numbers. I thought it started with 300-400 euros. And when did I start focusing on marketing? Around 1 year, I started more attention to my website and ads and so
on. Yeah, and you also told us you had some sponsorships with study associations. Could you tell us a bit more about that, maybe?
With some studio associations and I have a sponsorship, they can rent for me with a discount or use that for their active members and so.
Yeah, because a lot of study associations have activities with all their members, and for instance you can go then to laser game and rent it at your place.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's cool. Are there any more questions from the people watching? Maybe nothing.
No.
Well, do you have any last words you'd want to say?
Not really.
No. Okay. Well, I want to thank you for your for being here, and people can always contact you, Laser Game Verhuur Groningen.
Yeah.
And we will put your name on the website.
Yeah.
Oh, there's one more question. Do you have any tips on marketing? Did you do it yourself or did you hire people?
I did some things by myself, but I hired some people to make the website. And when I made the ads, I let them check with professionals. So my ads were good and the tracking was right. Otherwise, you spend money and won't get any result.
Yeah, so you did it yourself before. And
yeah.
All right. Do you plan on doing this for the rest of your life?
Kinda. Maybe I started another company, but for now it's my full-time job, so it's good for now.
Okay. Well, I see one more we missed. What did you think brought in the biggest crowds? The Google Ads, mouth-to-mouth, or some other partnerships?
It's somewhere between word of mouth is like 25% of my customers, partnerships 10, and the other is Google Ads and just on Google. So, yeah.
Yeah. Well, nice to know. What's your best tip for a good start?
Ask friends to judge your idea and give feedback. Just let them give critique and don't be afraid to lose money. You will get there eventually.
Yeah. If you invest now, you will get it back in the future.
Yeah. If you have a good plan, it will come good.
It will come flying at you.
Yeah.
Did you notice a lot more revenue growth after your marketing steps?
Yeah, when I started with the marketing, my revenue grew, and yeah, the more customers I've got.
Yeah, and it was a success. I mean, you've grown a lot the past years. What happens when people don't bring back the equipment or break it?
They always bring it back. Sometimes it breaks, but it's like very hufter proof. How do you say that?
It's a strong equipment.
Yeah,
it doesn't
strong
break
equipment.
That easy.
And when it breaks, they have to pay a fee.
Oh, so you have a plan before that. Yeah, that's also always a good start. Well, I believe those were all the questions.
Yeah.
If you have any left, you can always email you, I think, or just look him up on Google, Laser Game Verhuur Groningen. And then I'm gonna welcome the next guest. Thank you, yep. Huub. I'd give you an applause, but there aren't very many people here. All right. Next we have Tom Kellendonk here. He's from Beeldkameraden. And they are doing a lot with the video game, video stuff. They are also hosting this live stream. So Tom, welcome.
Thank you very much for having me.
Hi.
Hi. Could everyone.
Hi. Could you tell us something about your company and the things you do?
Yeah, sure. My name is Tom Kellendonk. I'm 24 years old and I'm currently a student communication and multimedia design at the Hanse here. And I think a couple of months ago I started with two friends of my the company Beeldkameraden. And in English it means something like video friends or something like that. Yeah, Beeldkameraden. Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's the right pronunciation. Yeah. We have the two of his friends are sitting on my left side.
Yeah. I have a picture of them. This is on the left. We see Mart Verstraten. He's a graduate from communication last year, and we have a dropout from a communication and multimedia design in the middle. It's Bas, and on the right it's me.
Yeah. So well, with Bas we see that you don't have to graduate in order to have success, right?
Not. It also it'd be handy to have a paper, but in the case of Bas, it's not essentially necessary.
No. So how did you get the idea to start this company?
Three of us guys all started from a young age with designing, making some videos. We all started like on high school, I think, little camera, VHS, like videotape and all kinds of things. And a couple of years ago, we all came together at the Studio Association by KIK. And there was right in the at the beginning, we had a very good feeling with each other. It was good samenwerking, was a good
partnership.
Collaboration, yeah. Thank you very much. It was a good collaboration, and we did a lot of projects together. At a moment, we were why we don't start a company together? And let's make nice things and great things. Yeah.
And when did you start expanding more? Because I know you had a lot of work to do last year with Corona and stuff. There were a lot of live streams. How did that? How did you market yourself and how did you find your customers?
It's a fun story. The most of our projects came from clients we already know, or they speak to clients we worked with. So really mouth-to-mouth advertisement. We don't even have a website yet. But we still have enough projects to work around. So that
you have so much work that you can't even... You don't even have to market yourself.
No, we don't have any time to make the website need. So if there's someone who can make a website, so please contact us. it would be appreciated. The things you do is like live stream. You something told that this is the things we do very often for lots of clients, like webinars, congressen. Something like that, but also we do for some DJs. We have some live streams, and it's very open and wild what we're all doing.
Yeah, you hosted the Knalfeest, DJ parties, also with the
in collaboration with Orde van de Nacht. It's a DJ collective, and we work with them.
Yeah.
And a lot of our this is some design things. Bas do for KIK, for example.
This is the merchandise from our Lustrum Week.
Yes. So and he made a lot more, like the little bands and other kind of things. He's very good in his work. And he likes to hear that.
Yeah. Oh, he's smiling behind the camera.
Yeah.
Did you have any second thoughts before actually starting off the business? And what made you push through?
It all starts very slowly. It's a progress, and when you first start on the high school, it's all like little jobs, and you learn a lot from them, and you work with people together, and then you do two jobs, and you think, okay, if you do two projects together, and it's like, yeah, it's not like the connection you want to be with them, so you try another people to work with, and yeah, I already told that at the beginning, at the start, the connection was great, and we really were good with each other. Yeah,
I think it's also valuable. It's also valuable that you you don't work alone. I mean, you are a student entrepreneur, but you have the three of you, and if you can't do something, then you can always ask the other person to do that.
Yeah, and that's also the best advice I can give someone who wants to start a job. If you don't know how something works, just ask it. Or ask people who know it well. I don't know anything about taxes from the belasting and all that kind of thing. But we have Mart, and Mart knows all about it. So if I have a question about it, I can go to Mart and ask, how does this work?
Yeah, so you'd say just to have a good network, and especially within your own company, it's great.
Yeah, network is everything. Yeah. Network, your jobs come from, your knowledge is come from that. So yeah.
Do you have any things you would have done differently, like that went completely wrong or you wouldn't do again?
Yeah, you always have some clients who that give you a headache because they want more for the same price, or they never made a video before. So when you come on set, they're totally unprepared and don't know what they want to do, and all that kinds of stuff. So but that's the slower progress of learning.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I see we have a question already.
Yeah.
How does something like this make enough money, especially since it's the three of you and you all need to be paid?
Yeah, just ask enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, not every job we take is for the three of us. Sometimes I do it on my own, sometimes we do it with two of us, or I do the filming and Mark does the editing, and we make upfront a calculation how much time it's gonna cost. And on base of that, we make an offerte.
I don't know the English word anymore.
you just a calculation of the price.
Yeah, and then you tell the customer.
Yeah, and we tell the customer now it's gonna cost this or it's gonna cost that, and then we are divided.
I think that's also like kind of a big problem. I also see at other students that if you get asked to do something like design a campaign or something, people are always afraid to ask enough money.
Yeah.
And well, your tip is you shouldn't do that.
No, especially not. And there is on the website on the KVK, it's the Dutch
Kamer van Koophandel, the registry for all the companies.
Yeah, for the companies, there is a link inside, and there you can see what the average
price is
per hour. Like for a graphic designer, it's that price. And also, if you are just started, or if you are a high professional, so that's something there you can use to think about your own price, what you want to make in the hour.
Yeah. Okay. So, are there any things you would have done differently, looking back? You've been at it for how long? Have you been at it right now?
For
how long did you? How long ago did you start your company?
I think we're working together like 2 or 3 years now, and the Beeldkameraden is the new branding of us, and that's now I think a half year I think.
Because you worked together before you actually.
Yeah, but we all were separated in different companies, so.
Yeah, because like each one of you also has a different. Special talent that you do all right.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and some companies we worked with are now on the screen right now. It's a 2MB. It's a drone company in Assen. We made a very big project for them at the Koloniën of Weldadigheid. It's this area where it's now World Heritage.
Yeah.
And we make for the provincie Drenthe, we made a drone video. MindSend Institute is a company what we make some e-learning programs for. Now, the Hans Hogeschool is also a very, very big customer of us. We work in lots of different departments, like from the communication side to different deans in different schools.
Yeah.
Now, Hollandse Nieuwe also, in Corona time, we made for them an online studio, something like this, to do their workshops, and we provided them with the necessary equipment and knowledge. And also we do a lot for studio associations because we like the doelgroep.
The people, because you're also all students, so you know the most people in here.
And exactly.
I know a lot of people also know about you, so
exactly,
they always ask you. Because you don't only do live streams, you also do designing and just make videos.
Yeah, after movies, weddings, we do everything.
Yeah, so... Did you have anything? You had a video, I believe, or
yeah, I've one of the first videos I want to like show you guys at home because I can tell a lot, but surely you want to see something. This is a part of I think it was was it introduction week? Yeah, there was. I think some of you guys saw it already. It was in our introduction week. It was the Silent Disco event. And we made in cooperation with Orde van de Nacht, the DJ Collective, we made very exciting evening. And this is just a small part of it. So some of you know we'll get kippenvel.
chicken skin
from the sound, I think, because we already know everything, the sound of Opus. So let's watch
brings
together.
Brings back all those memories.
Technique guys, you okay? Yeah? Okay, let's start. Yeah, a little bit of it. It's like a stream of 5 hours, I think. And
it was quite a long party, indeed.
It was quite a long party, yeah.
Yeah, and the streams are also, you can also find them on the YouTube account, right?
Yeah,
so if you
want to
watch the entire thing.
It's a very nice stream for just if when you're sitting with some people, just to have the background and you have some nice music and also a nice party for you, yeah.
Yeah, well, that's cool. Did you have anything else to show? Otherwise, we can go through the questions.
Yeah, another thing I do. That was like a bit the informal side of our company. We also do like formal stuff for like the companies I mentioned earlier.
Mm-hmm.
And this is like an after movie. We did not make the after movie. It was like the studio commission from Kick. But you get an idea what kind of events.
Yeah, this is a bit more of a behind the scenes of what you do.
Exactly. Yeah. So let's watch it together.
So this was the congress we organized last year, a bit like this, but way bigger.
Exactly, yeah.
And well, I see we have quite a few questions.
Great.
Do you also get requests for projects that you're just really not interested in? What do you do with them?
Ah, good questions. Yeah, money is money sometimes, and sometimes you need to do some jobs where you don't have any, where you don't have any feeling with. But the power of the three of us is we'll always make from it some. We'll also
make you always make have fun making it, even if it's not just a project you're doing,
and
but the people.
I also find it like a challenge to get the very serious people get a laugh or have a joke with them, and we also find it a kind of a challenge, I think.
Yeah, and I think even if you don't really like what you're doing, it's still a learning process, so you get to learn from it and you just have fun with the three of you.
Yeah, exactly. So if people come to us and they want to make that we make something for them, we're always listening and we're always
you'll find
ready
a way
to help. Yeah, we'll find a way to work around.
Nice. I have an interesting question. How did you get your school as a customer? It's quite a big deal. How did you get the Hans Hogeschool to ask
you for things? Yeah, it was a slowly process. I did a lot of open days at the Hanze, and I made a video, and via my network, they asked me to do a project, Klaar voor de Start, last year, and we made, I think, 20 or 30, maybe 40 videos with the three of us, four of us. For all the different departments of the Hanze. Last year, Corona year was a little bit different than it was now. A lot more has to go online. So we made 40 videos, I think. And also we made introduction videos like how work Blackboard, how does DigiRosa works, Hans.nl,
all tutorials.
We made everything, and some people really like the videos, and then they know your name.
Yeah.
And if they ask it, if they have something, they call you and they like, could you make like a video for our parents' evening, or could you like make a video of how can I sit aerodynamically in a chair, or something like that? It's a project of Mart last a couple of weeks ago. He had to make a video about how Hans's employees have to sit in a chair
in the right way, because they all have to go back to the office and sit in a chair again.
Exactly. So that's also like very fun project.
I see someone ask, what's your name again? His name is Tom Kellendonk and the company is Beeldkameraden.
Yes.
We'll put the name in the screen sometime. Is there a company that you still really want to shoot for? What would your dream project be?
Ooh, I did a dream project almost 2 years ago. I've been to Chernobyl.
Yeah.
I did my minor medialism here at the Hanze, and with a couple of friends I did go to Chernobyl to make that documentary. That was really a dream project to be there, to film there, and that kind of experience. But one thing I really want to do is I wanted to film from out of a chopper on a festival or like a big event, mm-hmm. or something like that. That's one thing I really want.
You
want
to shoot from the sky.
Yeah. And also I have a drone, so I've mostly the same videos I can make from a helicopter. But the experience of filming in a helicopter, that would be a dream, I think.
Maybe someday.
Yeah.
And what is your proudest moment so far?
Ooh, proudest moment. Now we did a really, really big project for Hollandse Nieuwe a couple of weeks ago with Talita Muus. That's a host from Op 1, the Dutch television show. I don't know.
Yeah.
And she was there, and we did a really good job to do that. Talk show, something like a talk show, and they also give us compliments after it. So that was a really, really proud moment of us.
Yeah, it's always nice to hear.
Yeah, from a really, really, really professional. We are also professionals, but really, really.
They've been at it for a lot longer.
Yeah, next level professional. Yeah. So that was like a proudest moment. And the video from 2MB from the the drone video for the UNESCO World Heritage. Yeah, it's just so small part, but because of that video, there are also World Heritage now.
Yeah, so you did that little thing and it had a big impact.
Yeah, exact. So I think that's well really proud moments, yeah.
Yeah, I understand. Are there any more questions? You can ask them in the chat, because I also have one for you.
Okay.
How do you see the future? Do you think you will go through with more live streams, or what's something you see?
No, live stream was especially in Corona times a really high topic. Lots of companies needed to get online things together, do the presentation in English of in online. So there was a really big gap in the market for us. You see now when Corona, the cases are dropping, that the demand of live streaming also is dropping. So, but we think that it still will be a thing in most of companies. So. Little less, I think, but I still think it will be demand will staying, yeah.
Yeah, because people will see your work and they will want the same.
Yeah.
And
you see also that it has a permanent thing in a lot of companies to do things online.
Yeah.
It's stupid to drive 2 hours, have a meeting of half an hour, and then drive 2 hours back. Let's do it online.
It did change the world, and there's a lot more video going on right now.
Exact.
And so in that case, Corona was quite good for you.
Maybe an eye-opener for a lot of people. You see it by lots of companies. They don't want to drive 2 or 3 hours for a meeting and then go back. It's stupid. And I think that was a really great eye-opener.
Yeah.
And also good for business for us.
More money.
Exact.
Yeah. We have another question. How would you describe success within your company? When do you know you made it?
Success is for me having fun with lots of nice people. I really like to work and help solving a problem for a client. And the client is, oh, you really helped us. That's the nicest feedback you can have.
Yeah.
And also I liked the working with the guys. And so I think that's probably the success. And success also, money. For me now it's a side business. For the two guys it's full time, and I hope it will be for me also a full time job at the end of my study. Yeah.
Because right now you are doing two things at a time. Maybe you could speak a little bit about that, how you combine the things.
Yeah. Last year I had your job at external coordinator for external affairs at KIK, and now I'm doing that by another association, the SSA.
Yeah.
So it's for me, it's two jobs at a time right now. Yeah.
And do you find it difficult to juggle all those things together? How do you plan ahead, or how do you divide your time?
Yeah, sometimes it's a bit of a struggle because you also have a social life and you want to do nice things. And it's really hard sometimes to get your calendar on the right tracks, something like that. But yeah, just plan it. And sometimes you have to say no to something as boss ask from, can you go next Wednesday on a job there and there, and I have an other appointment.
Unfortunately you have to say no. You have to know your boundaries.
Exactly. Yeah.
Okay, well, nice to know. Do you have any tips and tricks for students who might want to start their own business,
or? Yeah, just start.
Yeah,
there are lots of people who are hicking, I think, I don't know exactly what the English word for that, but they have a lot of excuse to don't start with it. Yeah, but I want to have one more customer. Yeah, but I don't have the equipment. Yeah, I don't have that. Just start.
Yeah.
Go to the KVK and register yourself for your own company. It's not so difficult, and if you need any help, just ask someone who knows.
Yeah.
Just start. That's.
And don't be afraid to fail either.
No, especially not. If especially when you work in your first year and you have a customer, they know who are they in business with.
Yeah.
So if you make a mistake and you call them and you say, I'm very sorry, but I can't make the deadline, or I'm very sorry, but I made a mistake, they understand that because you are a starter, and it's no problem. but communicate that. Communicate, I'm sorry, I've this, or I'm something like that.
Don't be afraid to admit.
Don't be afraid. No. And I think that's the most important, to communicate. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
I believe we don't have any more questions. No. Then thank you for your time, and we meet again. If you have any more questions, you can find him on the socials and the rest of the people as well, Beeldkameraden. And I would like to welcome our next guest.
Great, thank you very much.
Thank you for your time. Next up we have Sanne Heesbeen. She's coming to tell us about her company. Sanne, come in.
Hi.
Hi, welcome. Thank you for being here.
Yes, of course.
Well, I mean, I know, but can you please tell our watchers something about the company you own and the things you do?
Yeah, of course. Well, I'm Sanne. I will introduce myself a bit first, of course. I'm a third-year student at the Dutch Communication Program, and I'm doing my minor now, which is great. But I also have my own company. I started it last April, May, so it's I by far the smallest company that was presented here today, by far. But I think that's also a great opportunity, also for the watchers to get to know, well, what Tom just mentioned, just start. And well, that's what I did. Yeah. I had nothing and I was like, yeah, why not? And so, yeah, my company, of course, that's why I'm here. And my company is called Contento. Don't go to Google just yet because you can't find me. Yet, I still have to make a website, and I have
That's
to make
right.
a logo.
They still have to make a website as well.
Oh yeah, great. Oh well, then I'm fine by now.
Yeah.
But well, it's well, as the name says, Contento. It's a Spanish verb. It's in Spanish, it's like happiness or satisfaction or something like that. And the word content is in it as well because I make content. For now, I have a few clients that want me to do web design and develop a whole new website. That's what I do mostly. But I also write a lot of texts. A lot of people say, hey, you're a good text writer, so please write a text for a website. And well, if you do that, you can also like design the whole website. So yeah, that's what I do mostly. And well, I'm a bit of a hobby photographer, and well, I make videos as well, but not that good yet. Well, not as good as them, of course.
Yeah, so you're still starting up a
bit. Yes, yeah. Yes, that's true.
Yeah, so what are your plans? Because you just started, and I know you.
I always have plans. I'm very busy, of course, but well, I've learned that the steps don't have to be that big. They can be very small, so you don't have to focus on everything at the same time. You can focus on, well, becoming a better text writer, or maybe just learn yourself more Adobe programs, or just start making videos and go edit them. And that's what I do now, because, well, I can develop websites. Well, not from the bottom. I mostly design them. I know how to use WordPress. Yeah, of course. Well, and now I'm making a movie in my minor now, so now I learn how to, well, make good shots and how to interview people and how to edit a whole movie of 20 minutes. So, yeah. Well, I finish in January, so in January I hope I can make a proper movie.
Yeah.
So yeah, and that's a big lesson for me, because my steps were always, I think, too big. Like, I have the biggest plans in the world.
Yeah.
And then they were too big. So, well, in the end, it was always a bit disappointing, I guess. So, yeah, my plans in the future are small steps. And then in the end, and that's a whole year and year and year plan.
Yeah.
But I want to become like a very good content marketeer, so that I can do everything for clients, so that I don't have to say, well, I'm not that good of a photographer, so,
so you wanna
I can't
do everything.
That. Yes, of course, but well, now I can, so I have to learn. Yeah.
But you're teaching yourself all the stuff at the same time. How do you juggle all of that, the photography and the designing and the writing and the study, the minor
course,
you're doing?
Well, it's nice because I can combine it with my study. In the communication study, we learn the Adobe programs. We learned how to take pictures better. And well, that helps me a lot, but I noticed that I have to do a lot by myself at home as well. So, yeah. And well, you have to push yourself, of course, because a lot of people, they are coming home and they're like, oh, I studied a lot today, I'm so tired, so let's just watch another Netflix series. I do that as well, but I also come home and I'm like, okay, so I want to learn how to make pictures and I want to learn how to edit them. So I just start a Lightroom tutorial on YouTube and I'm like, okay, I'm going to watch it and do it step by step, and then after 1 or 2 days I know Lightroom from the inside and outside. So yeah.
And if you start small and you make tiny steps, yeah, then you will get somewhere.
Of course, the one week is better than the other week, but it takes time. You can't learn everything in 1 day or 1 week or even a year or 5 years. There's everywhere there's something new to learn. So yeah, I think I'm doing what I like mostly. So if I'm feeling like, okay, I want to make pictures, I'm going to make pictures and edit them. And if I like to know more about WordPress or other web design things, I'm going to do that and search for that.
So yeah, but that's also the beauty of having your own company. The thing is, you can divide your own time and you can plan ahead and schedule your own things.
Exactly.
How much time would you say you are spending at your own company, and how much time are you spending on your study?
Good question.
There's a lot of overlap.
Yeah, I always find it difficult to keep them separate, but I would say it takes a few hours a week. Just what I mentioned earlier, it's just how I'm feeling, and if I push myself, I can sit after behind my laptop for like a whole afternoon maybe, or a whole evening. And sometimes I'm like, yeah, I'm not feeling it, so today is not a good day, I want to watch a Netflix series. So
and you can do that.
Yeah, you can do that. And of course I have clients and I have to deliver and I have to do the projects, but you're the boss of your own time.
And the client won't notice if you're working at night or in the morning.
In the end you have to deliver, or you have to go to a meeting or evaluate something.
But yeah. I see we got a question. Do you have an hourly wage, and what do you tell your client about pricing, since it can be difficult to guess how many hours you will be spending on a certain project?
Yeah, good question. In the beginning, I find it very difficult to like come up with an hourly wage.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, I really don't know how much, and very difficult to say to someone, yeah, well, I want to do the project, but I have really no idea how much you have to pay me. So,
because most of the times the client also doesn't know how much money they are willing to spend and how much stuff like that costs.
If they didn't work with content marketers before.
Yeah.
So they're like, yeah, we also have no idea. So it becomes a very awkward conversation then. So I learned that it's good to have your hourly wage and just say it like, okay, yeah, I'm worth it.
Yeah.
You have to pay me this because I'm worth it, and be very, well, confident of that. But I ask around a lot, and I also Googled a lot. Google is my best friend now. And well, I do have an hourly wage, of course. But I'm a student. I know that if people hire me, they know that I'm a student. I'm still learning. So you can't ask, well, I'm a bit exaggerating, but you can't ask like 100 euros per hour. You can't do that. They will laugh at you and they were like, okay, we will find someone else. So yeah, I do have an hourly wage after hours and hours of searching and asking around. I just tell them like, yeah, I can make an invoice for you, and you have to pay me this and this. And most,
but do you tell them the hourly wage, or do you also tell them how many hours you will be spending? Because that can be difficult to tell.
It depends on the project, I guess, because one of my clients, last clients, they said like, okay, we need someone for about 50 hours in total.
Yeah.
And it's okay if you do that in weeks and weeks and weeks. We just want a good website, so take your time. We want you to spend 50 hours. And then I said, okay, I want to be paid this and this per hour. And they were like, okay, that's fine. So I made an invoice. And
yeah,
it's a bit, well, you have to feel how they feel about you and what you can and can't say, I guess.
Yeah.
and just be confident. Because in the beginning I was like, yeah, I don't, okay, it's I want this per hour, is that okay? And I was like, well, they want me because I'm good at what I do, so
yeah,
I can just say what I want.
And the companies also expect you to know what you're doing because you're the one
yeah.
with the business.
They ask yeah. me, so yeah. yeah.
So did you already have things you wanted to do differently? I mean, you just started, but well, did anything go wrong?
Not yet. I guess, well, one thing happened with a client where they said, okay, we want you to build a whole new website for us. They showed me their website. It was, I don't know if I can say that here on YouTube, but it was a shitty website with a lot of shit on it.
If you didn't say which website, they won't know.
Of course. But, well, they showed me. I was like, okay, I can do a lot for you. I can develop like a whole new design and a whole new corporate identity and, well, let's just say there was a lot wrong with it.
Yeah, there was a lot of work for you.
Yeah, of course. And they said like, okay, we want to send you, that was my first client, so that I wasn't even a member of the Chamber of Commerce mm-hmm. yet. So they were like, okay, we want to pay you and we want you to do this. And I was like, yeah, well, I'm not at the Chamber of Commerce, so yeah. you can't so pay me yet.
Officially
I can make invoices yeah. yet. So I had to do that first. And when I did, well, you have to pay 50 some euros to get there. And after I think a month, I already did a lot of work, a lot of research, stuff like that. They were like, yeah, well, the board of our company decided that they don't have the money for you. And I was like, what? That's like not the
not the way to go.
No, why would you ask me, make me like go to the Chamber of Commerce, like, yeah. hi, I want to start a company. I had to do research. Okay, what kind of company? Okay, I think I'm a content marketeer, a business name. I paid money and I made an invoice and I had a lot of contact with them
yeah.
and I did a lot of research. And then they were like, oh yeah, well, the board, in the end, they don't want to go through with it. I was like, what?
So you did all the work for nothing?
Yeah. So that was very weird. And I noticed that it like kind of overruled me. I was like,
you didn't know
okay.
what to do with it.
And I thought, well, they are the board, so I can't like speak up and say, well, I don't agree with that because they have to hire me. And so that was like I had a very weird position, I guess.
Yeah.
And the conversation was very awkward as well because I had a contact person who was not in the board, so it was like a very triangular
yeah.
situation, like a
you
relationship,
didn't have contact
but
with
then
the people
different.
That decided. Yeah.
So, but well, I think I kept quiet like for maybe a month. I was
mm-hmm.
like, I really don't know what to do with it. And they were like, yeah, we will keep in touch and we will let you know if we do have time for you or money for you.
Yeah.
And after a month, I started to think like maybe I just have to step up and speak up for myself, but
so you did.
Yeah, not in like a defensive way, or I didn't want to insult them, of course. But yeah, I just called them and I was like, hi, I really want to do the project for you. I'm just starting, I want to learn a lot. Maybe we can talk about my hourly wage as well. Don't know why I didn't think about it earlier. But and well, they were like, maybe we can invite you to come to a meeting with the board.
Mm-hmm.
So I went there and yeah,
and you got the job.
Yeah, it came out okay. So
so you stood up for yourself and it worked.
Yeah,
nice.
Yeah, and that's I think that's something that well a lot of people have to learn also in like their private lives to step up for yourself, speak up for yourself, but not in like a defensive or well you don't have to insult people.
No, you can just
like
be friendly and people.
Yeah, and well you have your private life, but you also have like your business life, and those are two completely different things.
Yeah, that's also good to know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that was a nice lesson to learn.
Always nice to, yeah. to learn stuff. We have more questions, I see. How did you learn to make a website, to build one, to design?
Well, the funny thing is, a lot of people, a lot of my friends don't even know that I can create websites, that I make them. They were like, what do you don't do? So I learned it myself completely. I just, well, I was a member of a volleyball association
mm-hmm.
back home, where my parents are still living. And they wanted a new website, so I said, okay, I can be the webmaster, I can do a lot of front-end things. But I found out that I really liked it, and I, well, learned everything myself by, well, YouTube tutorials, just asking around, asking people who did a study in ICT or something like that.
Also building a network.
Yeah, like, how do you do this? Because I don't know how it works, and can you maybe explain to me what I am doing wrong or what I can do better? And
Yeah,
just very much self-learning stuff.
Yeah. Okay, then we go on to the next question. If during a project you realize you will be taking more hours than you initially thought, what do you do then?
Good question. I will contact my client, of course. That's what I learned now. And most of the time I'm telling them why it takes more time, because if I just say like, yeah, it will take more time, they're like, oh, whoa, hold up, why? So I explain them why and in what segment, or in the design, or in the writing the text, or maybe taking photographs, or because I can, well, for example, deliver a website in the hours that they gave me, and it's like, well, halfly a shitty website still.
Yeah, so you have to finish.
Yeah, so that's what I explain them. It's like, I can make you a better website, but it will take more hours. And just always like have good and nice contact with your client and just explain what you are doing, because most of the time they have no idea what you're doing.
Yeah, and if you just tell them that, it will be all right.
Well, that's what helps me most. Yeah.
What programs do you use to create or design websites?
Well, most of the time, I found out that my clients work with WordPress. So, and I know WordPress, so that's a good thing. I know a few other programs as well, but not that good. But I think that if a client comes up with me and says like, okay, we want a website, but we use a totally different program, I won't immediately say no. I can tell them, well, I haven't worked with it a lot or not at all,
just be honest,
but I want to
experience.
Learn it. Well, I have my skills, I know a lot, I can help you, but I have to get to know the program first, so yeah.
Yeah, okay. How do people and companies contact you for a job or project? This will be the last question, because we are running out of time.
Yeah, well, I think mostly by word of mouth. First, people really didn't know that I had a company, so I started telling people, and I told them what I do and start explaining. And, well, they told each other, and they told friends, and they told family, and that's why one of my first clients was a friend of my mother. And you can think, wow, no friends
so
or family or stuff like that.
But like that.
Yeah, it's what Tom mentioned as well. Money is money, and if they want you to hire you, it's a good thing that, well, word of mouth there, and that, well, the friend of my mother is like, hey, I heard from your mother that you create websites
and
we need a new
one. Well, I want to thank you. We're running out of time, unfortunately, and people still need to sign up and stuff. Thank you a lot.
You're
welcome. If you want to find her name is Sanne Heesbeen. We'll probably also be somewhere on the socials. Then I have one last thing to say for you. If you want to put your attendance in, we have a QR code. I believe it's in the screen right now. Not. It will be. It's on screen right now. You can scan it, and then you put in your name and your student number, and your attendance will be noted, and then it's finished. Thank you again for your time.
You're
and
welcome.
Then we're done for today.
Woo!
gotta go, gotta go. Go, you gotta go, you gotta go. Go, gotta go, gotta go. Go, you gotta go, you gotta go. Go, gotta go, gotta go. Go, you gotta go, you gotta go. Go, gotta go, gotta go. Go, Dominique, say.
You.